much. We shall now go on to our next speaker, who is none other than our ARC member, Dr. Rohit Saxena, who is going to deal on toxic optic neuropathies, what every ophthalmologist should know. On to you, Dr. Rohit.
Thank you, Dr. Chitra. Am I audible?
Yeah.
I'll just do a full screen. So I'll be talking about toxic optic neuropathy and particularly about ethambutol toxicity, which is particularly an important consideration in India, and again, more so as we are evolving in the treatment. So toxic optic neuropathy is often kind of underdiagnosed or more truly delayed diagnosed because it mimics or it presents many other causes that can present in the same way. It characterized by the papillomacular bundle involvement and will present with central or centrosecal scotomas. These are a whole lot of conditions, drugs that are responsible for toxic optic neuropathy. In fact, the three of these are very important ATT drugs, antitubercular treatment, and considering the high amount of ATT being given in our country, it really becomes the most important toxic optic neuropathy. The other important one is, of course, alcohol induced, which I'll just touch about, but mainly I'll be talking about tuberculosis related. More so, this has become important because we've recently had the revised National TB Control Program, where we have where the guidelines have changed, and it's now a daily regimen. Ethambutol is also a part of the continuation phase. There are fixed dose combinations as per the weight band, and although the weight band tend to decrease the risks, but still, because they are in combination, the stopping the treatment also, or stopping ethambutol also, becomes rather difficult at times. And it's important because almost 25 lakh people or 2.5 million people are on ethambutol at the moment, any given time, basically as per government available numbers, but they may be higher because many may not be notifying to the government, although it's a notifiable disease. Always important to exclude other causes because LHON, as Ramesh pointed out, can present in that gradual loss of vision, one eye followed by the other. So toxic can be asymmetrical, and of course, many other conditions like infiltrative or compressive lesions. Also to remember, tuberculosis-related vision loss is not always because of toxicity, and you can have direct involvement of the visual pathway or tubercular meningitis causing hydrocephalus with secondary optic atrophies, and tuberculomas involving the visual pathway that can present with visual loss. And actually in them, they are actually breakthrough during ATT, and therefore you have to up the treatment instead of stopping, although ethambutol is still contraindicated in any tuberculosis with visual function deficit. So we're talking about consensus. I'll just run you through some of the consensus that we had achieved in this excellent meeting of neuroophthalmologists from India, which also included physicians and pediatricians. And we discussed about ethambutol optic neuropathy in light of the changing treatment regimens. And most of the people who are here were a part of this program. Because of that meeting, we were able to generate an alert that was sent to the TB program and then disseminated to all who are treating tubercular patients, including physicians and pediatricians. So what are our recommendations? Toxic optic neuropathy can occur anytime during ethambutol use, most commonly in the first 3 to 5 months. And although it's usually seen in higher doses, but no dose is absolutely safe. It presents with subacute bilateral visual loss, but it could be asymmetrical. Fundus may more often be really normal, but over time lead to disc pallor, and increased latency in the VEP is an early biomarker according to most studies. A very high index of suspicion because the patient often does not think that you need to know about his systemic problems or the treatment he is receiving. And of course, tuberculosis, almost everybody wants to hide. As an ophthalmologist, do opportunistic screening of every patient on ethambutol. There is no effective treatment, and therefore early detection is very important. Also remember, visual function may continue to deteriorate for a few weeks even after stopping the drug. So it's not something to panic, but up to a month you may see visual loss continuing. Among health workers, we talked about identifying high-risk individuals. That means patients receiving higher doses, they are low weight in the weigh band, receiving longer durations, drug-resistant TB, or those with extrapulmonary COX, patients with renal dysfunction, diabetes, tobacco, alcohol, combined therapy with linezolid, pre-existing visual function deficit, and young pre-verbal children. They are all high risk, need closer follow-up and definite evaluation by an ophthalmologist. All should undergo baseline examination and at least a visual acuity every 2 months. And non-high-risk patients should go a visual function examination at 3 and 6 month follow-up, preferably if possible at the physician level. For the physicians, avoid ethambutol and pre-existing optic neuropathy. Make the patient aware without raising an alarm. Follow up, ask for visual dysfunction, a very key thing, because most physicians, even if told about visual dysfunction by the patient, think it's a progressive cataract or something and say that after the treatment is over, go visit an ophthalmologist. These examinations like color and visual acuity can be done by the physician, and a high risk or a high sensitivity for physicians to pick up any visual dysfunction. If diagnosed, replace ambutol immediately. At the community level, create the awareness. For the patient, they must be educated, given Amsler grid or a pocket Snellens, use the Nixchay app, record any pre-existing visual impairment, and also record any adverse reaction to the drug. Management, we really, there is very little. Stop, replace ethambutol, multivit supplementation, including zinc, good nutrition, regular follow-up. The only other thing we often see is methanol toxicity, which is sudden onset loss of vision. The only important thing is they get excavated discs over time and sometimes are misdiagnosed for glaucoma. And basic, again, overall toxic management, exclude, remove the toxin offending agent, vitamin supplementation, hydroxycobalamin injections, maybe in methyl alcohol toxicity, treat the cause. And of course, many people have tried IV pulse steroids for toxic things, but really there is no role of IV methylprednisolone in any of this. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rohit. That was a great talk. You covered all the relevant questions which I thought I'd ask you.